Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming out here today and being here for this very special occasion. We're here today, Veterans Day, to celebrate all veterans. We're also here today to celebrate this Eagle Scout project of Xander's, of redoing this Veterans Memorial. So I just wanted to welcome you all and thank you for coming. I will turn this over to Xander, but I wanted to tell you everyone that I'm very proud of him, the job he did here, and I think it's a fitting tribute for those who are laid to rest here and elsewhere. So, thank you, Xander.
Good afternoon, everybody. So a little bit about the project. When I first got here and we took a look at Greenwood, we took a look at this site over there and this one. I decided I liked this one a little bit better because of the way the arch would look with the flags. There was a few spots of concrete that were kind of chipped and it needed a little painting. And then we decided that we were going to add the 5 flagpoles to the memorial, one for each branch of the military. They are 25-foot flagpoles, and the flags alone costed us, the flags and flagpoles alone cost us about $7,000, $8,000. So it was pretty expensive. So we did the flagpoles and then we came in and mulched around the flagpoles, put in shrubs, and then repainted the entire facility as well as the cannonballs and cannons off to the sides. The reason I did this project was because it connected close with me and made me strive to want to complete it because I'm planning on joining the military after high school, and to honor those who have fought and served for our country, it's close to home. So that's why I did the project, and I appreciate all of you who helped support it, the community who reached out and donated, and all the support that I got. So thank you.
Now I'd like Mr. Dan Peters to step up. Dan is the general manager of Greenwood Cemetery.
Man, I don't even know where to start with this guy. Greenwood has always taken pride in honoring veterans. We have 4 military sections on this cemetery. One specifically for World War I vets, World War II vets. GAR has veterans from probably every American war minus the Revolutionary War. But in March, I got a message that this gentleman was wanting to do an Eagle Scout project here at Greenwood. And we get those requests frequently. And sometimes the scope is a little above what they're looking to do. And along with this proposal, I got this handwritten, hand-drawn picture of the memorial here with the flagpoles drawn in, and it was just amazing the time that he put into his proposal. So we sat down and talked, met in person, and when I got the quote for the flagpoles, I thought, man, this is going to be a big project. And I told Xander what the cost was. He said, okay, never flinched. And I knew that the project was going to get done. He calls about 2 months later and says, man, I got it. But I got some other things working, and I think we can do a little better. And he did. Came up with the paint, the landscape. Last week, had an electrician out that put on lighting. What he's done here is just an awesome gift to the cemetery, and we couldn't be more thankful. It's such a great way to honor our vets, past and present, and we just have met and just have a great friend in Xander and his grandfather. On behalf of Greenwood Cemetery, the employees here, and the families we serve, we just want to say thank you to Xander. He's just a remarkable young man, and the things that he's going to accomplish in the future, I think, are going to be immeasurable. So thanks for coming out, everybody. We appreciate it.
So I know we have some very special guests in the audience that would like to speak. So I'm going to call Sarah Carruthers up to the podium and let her say what she'd like to say. Thank you.
Xander, I have a little present for you from the House. On behalf of the members of the House of Representatives of the 133rd General Assembly of Ohio, we are pleased to pay tribute to Xander Roberts for all that you've done and attaining the Eagle Scout rank. Your impressive credentials as a Boy Scout readily confirm how very worthy you are of this esteemed honor. Thank you so much, Xander. I don't know if you even know how very proud we are of you in Columbus and in Hamilton. Greenwood Cemetery is so important to our community and so important to our history in Hamilton that to have someone this young care about it and to care about our veterans is just very, very meaningful, I think, to all of us and should be. So thank you so much.
We have Mayor Pat Moeller, Mayor of the City of Hamilton. Thank you, Pat.
Good afternoon. I want to thank Xander for the Flags for the Fallen. I had the opportunity to be at his Eagle Scout court on Saturday, and that was a very impressive event. But you have added to this sacred ground. Just behind this podium is a gentleman named Fred Brown, who's buried. Fred Brown was in the Vietnam War, middle of a firefight. He went in and saved some of his fellow soldiers from the middle of that firefight. They were injured. He went in, came back out with a fallen soldier. Went in, came back out with a fallen soldier. Went in a third time, got mortally wounded. Buried just behind this podium. What you've done is for him and all the veterans buried here at Greenwood. You're a fine example of a Hamilton High School student. You're a fine example of Navy Junior ROTC. You're already a leader. We look forward to what you're going to accomplish in the future. Thank you very much, Xander.
My heart is racing. So I'm going to talk about some veterans here for a minute. Ever since I was little, ever since I can remember, I've always wanted to serve my country. It was either that, like joining the military, becoming a firefighter, or becoming a police officer. So serving has always been in my heart, and I've always wanted to do it. And so I started scouting. And in scouting, I met veterans all the time. We went to Wright Patt Air Force. We went to naval bases. We met veterans all across the country. And it was a really cool thing to talk to them, hear their experiences, and hear their stories. And then here lately, about 2 years ago, I joined the Navy Junior ROTC program at Hamilton High School, where I just met even more active duty or retired military members, and they became role models for me, some of the biggest role models I've had in my life. So I really want to thank all the veterans that are still alive today for being such good role models to me and some of my friends who feel the same way. I also want to thank the family members of those who have died in the line of battle for our country. The main reason I did this project was so that way they'll never be forgotten. And I hope that if you come here to the cemetery to visit one of your loved ones, that I hope this makes you feel like they are not forgotten, because that was the point of the project. At this time, we will be reading the names that people who donated to the project sent in to us, so that way we could read them at this dedication ceremony. In memory of Fred Bailey, U.S. Army veteran, Henry R. Butterfield, U.S. Army, World War II. Harold Coates, U.S. Navy. Curtis Caldwell, U.S. Navy. Gunnery Sergeant Ralph Rogan Crothers, USMC, Korean War. BMC Henrik Kodo, U.S. Navy. Joe Copas, Colonel, U.S. Army. Melvin E. Dalton, U.S. Navy. Fred Englehart, U.S. Army, World War II. Russell J. Field, World War II. Mike Farmer, United States Marine Corps. James Grays. Robert Hurled, U.S. Army, Korean War. Joseph Kirst. Paul Miller, U.S. Air Force. Norman Knabb, U.S. Army, World War II. Captain David G. Noland, USMC. Harold J. Peters, U.S. Navy. Thomas Rist. Captain Carl Arthur Roden, U.S. Army, World War II. William F. Thurman, World War II and Vietnam. William Truster, U.S. Army. Robert Wolf, U.S. Navy and Korean War and World War II. Harold Douglas, Jack Walton, U.S. Navy. Sergeant John L. Ware, U.S. Army. Fred Englehart, U.S. Army, World War II. McGilvery Douglas, U.S. Army. And Carl Condrit, U.S. Army, World War I. Thank you to all who donated, and I just appreciate it. I couldn't have done it without you guys. It was a huge undertaking, $12,000 in total. We gave Greenwood a check for $11,000, but if you add up the amount of donations in supplies from all the businesses that we reached out to, it's about $12,000, and the community support really just blew me away. I never thought in 2 months we'd raise $11,000. So thank you to everyone, the city of Hamilton, for stepping up, especially during this time where we have a global crisis.
Thank you very much for coming. Right now we'd just like to have a moment of silence before we play taps. So if you just bow your head and just have a moment of silence. Thank you.